Now I am dictating 90 words per minute. Get ready. 10 seconds more. 5 seconds. Start. I would like to know only 2 or 3 things from the Honorable Minister. Going by the increase in the arrivals, have you made sufficient arrangements to regulate their purchase or to open more purchase points at your first meeting? Did you formulate any purchase plan, keeping in mind the estimated production? It is the farmers who suffer most in the absence of any such plan, because they are in hurry to get their produce to the market. In the absence of the purchaser in the market, at that time the farmer is compelled to sell off his produce at very cheap and unremunerative prices. This condition exists not only in this case, but in other cases as well. I would like to insist that if you have formulated any purchase plan in this regard, the farmers should be informed about it. They should be informed about it with the help of various farmers' organizations. You should see to it that the farmers do not suffer as a result of the fall in prices due to increased arrivals in the market. Many of our friends and the Honorable Minister in his statement has talked about some federations, and it was mentioned here that these federations had sought the permission of the government to directly export, which would enable these federations to protect the interests of the cotton growers in their respective regions. A lot of discussion in this regard has already taken place. I would like to know whether this demand of theirs has been thoroughly examined, because our cotton growers are today at the mercy of big mill owners. Two kinds of pressures work on the Cotton Corporation of India. On the one hand, it has to bear the pressure of commercial organizations, and on the other, it has to help farmers also. Thus, two kinds of pressure work on it. However, CCL are unable to put any pressure on the mills. Under such circumstances, the private mill owners join together and create such a situation within the scheme that the farmers are left with no option but to sell their produce at very cheap prices. My friend Sir Purohit had said that the mill were running at a loss. by the present situation. I do not think that there would be even a single mill owner who would not endeavor out to wipe out all his previous losses. With barely a day or two to go before the center has to start evicting out of town allottees from government bungalows and flat in accordance with the Supreme Court's order, the government is caught in a piquant situation. It is on the one hand under tremendous pressure from the bureaucracy to promulgate an ordinance which would regularize the allotments. The Supreme Court has found fault with, on the other hand, any effort on its part to do so would inevitably be challenged in court, with the government being charged at contempt of court for trying to circumvent the Supreme Court's order to evict out of town allottees by the third week of June. What has further complicated matters for the government is the Supreme Court's at least stand on the issue. When the center approached the court last Friday for clarifications about allottees who were asked to vacate their premises but had since then become entitled to their accommodation, the judges said that the government should make the allotment to them only after evicting them first. In another context, it noted that it is not the government to implement the court's judgment. The court has, in fact, over a period of time, rejected as many as 30 review petitions, which ranged from pleas that they be allowed to retain their accommodation on humanitarian grounds to requests for waivers on the penal rents imposed on VIPs. Earlier, in accordance with the Apex Court's order of December 1996, that the irregular allottees be evicted within 6 months, eviction notices were served on about 2500 government employees in the middle of March. The 90-day period given for vacating the premises comes to an end on June 16, with the last batch of persons served notice having to evict them by June 23. Should they fail to vacate this by the stipulated dates, as many of them have failed to do so far, the government was directed to evict them. With the bureaucracy, particularly its top brass, which comes in the court verdicts ambit, exerting its pressure on the government, the same center has been examining the possibility of promulgating an ordinance before the court's deadline for the evictions sets in early this week. While the draft text of the proposed ordinance has already been vetted by the Prime Minister's office, with the law and finance ministries also reportedly called upon for their views. President Shankar Dayal Sharma appears to have been sounded about it, sources indicate. If you like the video, please click on subscribe button or also like.